Hello everyone, welcome to the channel. To understand the concepts very clearly, please watch the video till the end. Once you are done with watching the video, do not forget to like, comment, subscribe and hit the bell icon. Today we're gonna learn about some character functions, right? When you're working with data, you get the values in characters, and to deal with that, you require to have knowledge about some more specific and many more character functions. So what is it that we're gonna learn today? So today we would have to learn how to deal with blanks when you have character data, right? So the first challenge which you get is blanks, blank values. So when you get the data, there are blank values comes with the value which appears in your table. Now there are kind of blanks which we have named over here, and that those are universally used. Let's look at that. First, it comes trailing blanks. What are the trailing blanks? Let's look at the definition. What does definition says? Definition says blanks at the end of the string. Whatever blanks appears at the end of the string, those are referred to be trailing blanks. Let's look at an example. So here you can see a name which is Thomas. Now where is the blank? So the blank is here. This part is referred to be the trailing blanks. Alright, hope you understand. Next, we have leading blanks. As the name itself suggests, the blanks which appears at the beginning of the string are referred to be the leading blanks. All right, let's look at an example. So here, where's the blank? Here, this blank will be referred to be the leading blanks, this one. And this one is the trailing blanks. Let's look at the next. Next, it comes blanks in between. Meaning you have two strings, and whatever blanks come between those two strings refer to be the blanks in between. So let's look at the example. Where is the in between blank? This part is the in between blank. This part is called the in between blank. So there are three kind of blanks: trailing blank, leading blank and blanks in between. It's a these are very, very simple. You can just keep on your fingertips, right? So let's look at the functions which helps us to deal with the blanks. There are unnecessary blanks which are not actually required. If you look and in this example, if this space is just one character, then if this is just one space, then it is useful and that makes sense. But if it is more than one space, then that does not make any sense. This type of blanks does not make sense. This type of blank does not make sense usually. So how you can deal with that? For that, we have some couple of functions. What all are those functions? Let's look at them one by one. First comes trim, then trim n, then strip, then compress, and then compile. So these are the most frequently used functions to deal with the blanks in your character data. Alright, so what all are the options which we're gonna discuss in this video? The options which we're gonna discuss are compress and compile. Rest of the functions are not in the scope of this video, and those are pretty simple. If you understand compress and compile, those are going to be very, very simple to understand. Alright, I would give you a view of them at the end. Let's look at the definition one by one. First, compress, what does it do? It removes all the blank spaces from your data. Let's look at an example. Here, we have a name, Thomas Cruz MapAuthor, right? So let me tell you, he is none other than Tom Cruise, right, of Hollywood. His full name is Thomas Cruz MapAuthor 4, right? Anyway, that's not our topic. So here, if you look at this space, it says, there are four blank spaces over here. Here there are seven blank spaces over here. So what will happen when you use compress function with this kind of a string? This will remove all kind of spaces from your character value. So your value would start look something like this. Do you see this? It removes all these spaces. All right. Now let's understand the compBL. What is compBL? Its definition says this translates or compresses more than one consecutive spaces or blanks into one. Meaning, if there are more than one blanks, for that matter, in this example you saw here, there are seven blank spaces. So if you use compress, this will remove all the blank spaces between two strings, or maybe at the beginning or at the end. Compress, leading, and whatever blank spaces are there, it removes all of them, right? But how does compBL is different from them? CompBL, when you use compBL, it does not gives you the output something like that. Let's see what kind of output it gives us. So when you use that, so this is the problem statement, same as the previous one, four blank spaces, and over here seven blank spaces, right? Now when you use compBL, what happens? This kind of information you get. This makes more sense, because usually you like to keep the names, full names, something like this, all right, separated by a single space. All right, now let's look at the SAS session and try to do it practical. All right, let's create a sample data sample, and let's create a variable called name, and let me put his name, this name over here. Let's make sure that there are just one space in between, and then run this. For our convenience, let's take the length of this. How many characters are there in name? All right, and let's run this. So you can see its name length is 21 characters. All right, now let's put some space in between here. All right, and then run this. Now you can see this is 27 character. It has become 27 character. All right, now let's use the compress function. I'm gonna keep the variable name as compress, so that we could relate it easily. Compress and name. Now this will compress the information, and to check that, we would have another variable called len2, and here we'll check the length, whatever comes in this variable. All right, now let's run this. Here you can see previously its length was 27, and we can see many blank spaces in between the strings. Now look at this. It has removed all these spaces from in between, and now the length is just 19 characters. All right, now let's go and try compBL. Name, enter, and let's take its length. Length to, and let's run this. So let's look at compBL. Now you can see it is separated by single space, and the length is 27 character. All right, same as original. It shouldn't be same as original. It's 30, and here it is also 30. Oops, I need to provide compBL, not the name, because we have converted in compBL variable. Right, now let's look at this. Now you can see it's just 21 characters long. So this is how you can use compress and compBL. There is one more use of using the compress option, right? Let's say you have the other use of compress function could be to remove some specific characters from a string. Let's look at another example. We will take a combination of alphanumeric values. sample 2. And the values, here we go. Now put anything, or let me just put alphabets, then numbers, and then some specific symbols, and maybe this, alright, and then run. Let's run this value. Syntax. Let's run this syntax. So here we have this value. Now we want to remove these two things. This is not absolutely not making any sense over here. This semicolon and this percentage. So how you can remove that? Just look at new value. Let's create a new value variable and use the compress function. For that, first you need to provide the source and then the character which you want to remove. This is very simple. You can just put whatever you want to remove within single quotes and you can just hit run. Now you can see the specific characters have been removed. Now along with this, there are some modifiers which can be used. All right. For example, let's say we want to remove the alphabets. Let's try to remove the alphabets. All right. So it has just removed not all the alphabets. For example, let's say we want to remove this SDLK, or maybe we want to remove all of the A values, right? Let's just remove all of the A values and let me put one A small and one A capital. Let's try this. So here you can see the small A has been removed, but the capital A still exists. All right. Now let's look at the actual syntax of compress function. What does it say? So if you look at the function, it says, its syntax says, first put the source, then provide the character which you want to remove, and then provide the modifier. All right. So we have provided the source, we have provided the character which we want to remove. Now we need to provide the modifier. So we're going to provide I. I says ignore the cases. Now let's see what happens. Run this. Now you can see both of the A have been removed from here. All right. So this is how you use the modifier with compress. Now let's look at another modifier. For example, we want to remove all the number values from this string. How we can do that? First, provide the source and the characters which we want to remove. We're gonna keep that empty. Just put single quote twice and then under single quote put D. D is the modifier over here. Now just select that and run it. You can see all the digits have been removed. Similarly, you have many modifiers over here. You can just take a screenshot of this. I encourage you to take a screenshot of this and keep it with you. Whenever required, you can use that. Utilize that. So you can use all of these modifiers to remove unwanted things from the string. All right. And this is the another use of compress function. So there are two things which you can do with the compress function. One, you can remove the blank, you can remove all kind of spaces, and the other, you can remove the required characters from the string. So this is how you can use compress function and compile function. Now, if you see at this screen, we have explained all of the functions which helps us in removing the unwanted spaces, right? You just take a screenshot of this and try using that and tell me in the comment section if you face any kind of problem, and put your code over there. I'll definitely review that and I'll come back to you. Thank you very much for watching the video. Wish you very good luck.